Cislunar Industries is a Colorado-based startup specializing in energy and matter in space, from space metal foundries to high-power systems for electric propulsion, beaming, computing, and more. It plays a key role in the ISAM market, that's in-space assembly and manufacturing, a rapidly expanding sector vital for commercial and defense applications. Cislunar, by the way, means the region between Earth and the Moon, although Cislunar has plans for the Moon, but we'll get to that later. Cislunar originally created its power systems to meet internal needs for its space-based metal foundry concept. In 2024, as demand for high-power systems in space surged, the company pivoted and began offering these internally developed solutions as commercial products to customers. Their vision is a thriving economy in space, where energy and matter are harnessed and reshaped to build an abundant, resilient future. Nearly everything in space runs on electricity, and PPUs, or power processing units, are critical components that convert electricity from a source, like solar panels, to the exact voltage needed for other spacecraft systems, like electric propulsion thrusters. This component is a common source of mission failures and a limiting factor on the capability of a spacecraft or satellite. Next, we'll examine the company's power units, followed by its in-space metal foundry concept and lunar plans. Power solutions for satellites and spacecraft. Cislunar Industries designs its PPUs for high-voltage applications, such as Hall-effect thrusters and nuclear electric propulsion rockets. These units offer greater compactness and efficiency than many competitors. The company claims its systems produce 3 times less waste heat and weigh 4 times less than traditional PPUs. For instance, they were able to supply ThinkOrbital with a 20 kilovolt power supply for their electron beam welding demonstration. Cislunar's PPUs now boast flight heritage from 2 2024 missions and a 2025 orbital demonstration for Momentus. Their radiation-hardened units guard against common failure modes, including power surges, a top killer of satellites. Now let's examine the company's power units. Cislunar Industries Mod PPU 1000 is designed and tested for use on modern Hall-effect thrusters. The company's larger model, the PPU 6000, withstands the higher radiation environments in geostationary orbit and beyond. Cislunar's top-of-the-range model, the ultra-high-voltage power supply, suits applications such as electron beam welding, as demonstrated in the ThinkOrbital mission, laser communications, powerful ion thrusters, and even nuclear electric propulsion rockets. Now, let's explore the company's even more intriguing concept, Space Metal Foundry. Cislunar's Metal Space Foundry, or MSF. Cislunar Industries holds a US patent for its apparatus for melting and reshaping metal in space, which enables the production of metal ingots or rods in orbital environments. You may think, where is the metal coming from? Well, space is littered with defunct satellites, upper stage rockets, and even nearby asteroids. You will be surprised how often asteroids come close to Earth, and sometimes even become captured into the Earth-Moon system for a short time. The company's in-space foundry recycles and fabricates metal components from captured structures or debris in orbit. According to the patent abstract, Cislunar's foundry comprises several key components: a crucible that uses electromagnetic induction to melt raw materials, an inlet to feed materials into the crucible, and a nozzle to channel the molten metal into a mold, where the metal is reshaped into useful forms without depending on gravity. This foundry can process metal scraps into beams, rods, or custom shapes. The design allows for extrusion, casting, or additive manufacturing processes in orbit. This patent explains the foundational technology for Cislunar's vision of establishing a self-sustaining space economy with future applications on the Moon and Mars. Cislunar calls their foundry the MSF, or Modular Space Foundry. Gary Kalnan, the company's CEO, has said the company is laser-focused on in-space metal processing. NASA has funded Cislunar's development of their metal foundry. NASA wants to reduce the enormous amount of waste humanity has placed in Earth orbit, such as rocket upper stages, defunct satellites, and random pieces of floating debris from satellite collisions. As more and more satellites are launched, the risk of collisions increases, which could be disastrous if left unaddressed. Specifically, NASA awarded Cislunar Industries a $750,000 small business grant to create an electromagnetic induction furnace that operates in vacuum and generates valuable materials from space debris. Several space startups are developing propulsion systems that use metal to generate thrust. These systems apply an electric arc discharge to a metal rod, which vaporizes and ionizes a small portion of its surface to create plasma. Electromagnetic forces then accelerate this plasma to produce thrust, eliminating the need for grids, neutralizers, or pressurized tanks. Both Newman Space and MagDrive, a setup that I've covered on this channel, are working on these innovative drive engines. Cislunar Industries, with its in-space metal foundry, could recycle metallic waste into propellant rods suitable for such vehicles. Cislunar has secured $800,000 in funding for a Phase 2 study on its metal foundry. The project will focus on creating a standardized output product and developing a microspace foundry testbed for near-term orbital demonstrations, potentially aboard the ISS. The company continues to refine the technology through parabolic flights. In 2024, it successfully cast its first aluminium billet in microgravity. Space-based metal foundries would enable repairs and upgrades to existing orbital platforms. Think Orbital has already demonstrated electron beam welding, and with multiple startups advancing metal propellant engines, waste could be transformed into fuel. These foundries could also be used for the construction of large metal trusses in space, ideal for communication arrays or solar power satellites that span hundreds of meters, or in some designs, several kilometers in length. Now, let's examine the company's plans for a metal foundry on the moon. Lunar Space Foundry, or LSF. The foundry technology developed by Cislunar could easily be adapted to support a lunar foundry. The main adjustments involve accounting for minor settling of molten metal under the moon's low gravity and shielding the system from abrasive lunar dust, which infiltrates everything. The company proposed this lunar foundry design as part of DARPA's Lunar 10 study on commercial lunar surfaces. In my previous video about Northrop Grumman's proposed lunar rail network, Cislunar's lunar foundry produces the rail tracks. It processes inputs such as scrap metal from defunct landers or rovers, regolith, or slag to yield ingots, rails, beams, sheet metal, cables, wires, and even mining equipment. This lunar foundry evolves directly from Cislunar's orbital metal foundry. It melts, alloys, casts, extrudes, and shapes materials into practical products for lunar use. The moon's regolith is rich in metals like iron, aluminium, and titanium, all excellent metals for construction. Aluminium can be used for wiring. It's not as efficient as copper wires, but it's abundant on the moon, unlike copper. Other space startups, such as Ethos Space Resources, aim to extract oxygen from regolith for propellant. They could sell the resulting deoxygenated regolith to Cislunar. This pre-reduced metal-rich material provides excellent feedstock for the lunar foundry. In its DARPA study, Cislunar described the lunar foundry as weighing approximately 5 tons and occupying a compact 10 cubic meters. Notably, a single Starship vehicle with its 120-ton dry mass and 80% recoverable metal could serve as feedstock to produce about 10 kilometers of rail track. Another promising application involves fabricating aluminium wires on the moon instead of shipping copper cables from Earth. These wires could form long-distance power cables to establish a lunar grid, linking solar arrays, lunar habitats, fuel cell systems, and nuclear power stations into a unified network. NASA is already exploring the idea of producing aluminium cables to support kilometer-length cables for power transmission on the moon. The ecosystem, competitors, partners, funding, and supply chain. YOLO Robotics has also received NASA funding to develop an in-space foundry, employing the same electromagnetic induction method for melting metals. This positions them as a direct competitor to Cislunar Industries, though Cislunar leads in technological advancement. Cislunar has highlighted various partners in-space manufacturing, including Axiom Space, Sierra Space, Lockheed Martin, and others. For its Lunar Foundry, the company could supply rail tracks to support Northrop Grumman's proposed Lunar Rail Network. Astroscale and other space startups involved in orbital debris could capture and transport debris to the in-space foundry for conversion into useful materials. Current funding comes from NASA and the US Space Force. NASA would likely value an in-space foundry for manufacturing parts to repair or upgrade systems. A lunar foundry would advance NASA's Artemis objectives by enabling sustainable living on the moon. Other governments and agencies might fund orbital debris removal efforts. Several startups such as Newman Space and MagDrive are pioneering metal-based propellants and could become future customers for Cislunar's products. Future commercial space station operators such as Vast Space, the Starlab Consortium, and Orbital Reef may be interested in the fabrication of parts or components to extend their stations. Upcoming events. In February 2026, Cislunar plans to launch one of its PPU units on board Momentus' Vigorade 7 orbital space vehicle. This mission will conduct in-orbit testing of the company's next-generation PPU technology and power management systems. This technology aligns with NASA's ISAM objectives in space assembly and manufacturing. It also validates that Cislunar's power systems can support foundries in space and on the moon's surface. What do you think of the concept of metal foundries in space or on the lunar surface? Share your thoughts and opinions in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with late-breaking space news and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.